Howdy, folks. This is Art Baker in Pasadena, California. This is the story of the Member Benefit Program. This evening, you'll be hearing comments from society leaders and songs from society champions. If you'll excuse a personal identification, we could easily call tonight's program You Ask For It. You have asked for the facts about the Member Benefit Program through the pages of a special issue of The Harmonizer, which arrived at your homes just recently. Now the time has come to hear how your society leaders feel about this progressive new program. It's our pleasure to take you now to the Tulip Capital of America, where we'll hear from our society's international president, Clarence Jalving of Holland, Michigan.
Thank you, Art, for that very flowery introduction. And by the way, I think everyone should know that Art Baker, in addition to his many national radio, television, and motion picture appearances, finds time to be an active barbershopper in our Pasadena, California chapter. I think the most important message I can bring you tonight is that the Member Benefit Program is not a fly-by-night, ivory tower type of planning. Your international officers have devoted a tremendous amount of time to the development of this program. The most important part of this plan is that no one person or no small group will benefit from this increase in member services. Every member will benefit greatly. I urge you to support your international officers by thoroughly studying every aspect of the Member Benefit Program. I'm convinced that after such a study, you will agree with the decision of your International House of Delegates at our recent Dallas Convention that this is what most of our members want and need. I'm proud to have been a part of the development of this program. I sincerely hope that every barbershopper across this vast society of ours will exercise his personal vote on this subject prior to his district fall convention. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to attend your chapter meeting tonight. I only wish I could visit personally with each one of you.
Thank you, President Jalving, for those remarks. From Michigan, we travel to the Rocky Mountains, where we find four familiar young men standing by to say a word to all of us. You know them best as the 1960 International Champions. Here's tenor Turk Evans of the Evans Quartet in Salt Lake City, Utah.
Hi, gang. I want to extend a big four-part howdy to all of you on behalf of Press, Jack, Gene, and myself. You know this being a champion is a tremendous responsibility. But we know that you fellows have an even greater responsibility because you're the ones who determine the future of our society. We've visited with enough of you during the past 3 years to know that a subject as important as the Member Benefit Program will receive your thorough consideration before your district convention. I can assure you our votes will be cast here in Salt Lake, and we know you'll be casting yours too. Now, we'd better act like champions or you guys will think we've gone into retirement. If our lead sounds a little shaky this evening, don't worry about it. He's going to be a bridegroom in just a few days. Okay, press, if you can pull yourself together, let's extend our official greeting to our fellow barbershoppers everywhere.
Now we are here to sing for you. We hope you like our style. We're happy that we have this chance to be with you a while. So sit right back, forget your cares, don't worry about a thing. We hope you'll all enjoy yourself. listen to us sing. Sweet Adonai.
Sweet Adonai.
That's the way the quartet sang back in good old granddad's day.
But today we sing the barbershop style in a slightly different way.
First we take a chord. Then we diminish it.
Then we turn it inside out and see what happens.
Whoa! Man alive, that's really right. That's the barbershop song.
You've just heard the Evans Quartet, our current international champions from Salt Lake City, Utah. Now, many words have been written and spoken about the member benefit program, and it would be difficult to quote everyone in this short space of time. However, we would like for you to hear the way one chapter president presented the story to his members. The president is Mel Burkett of Odessa, Texas. After attending all sessions of the International Board and House of Delegates at the Dallas Convention, this is how Mel reported the member benefit program to his chapter. He said, "These items of information are compiled in attempting to supply as many answers as I can to our chapter members regarding the various questions and considerations that have been brought up in discussions about the proposed new activities and services and the necessary dues increase required. The first thing I think I should do is to qualify the integrity, responsibility, and sincere desire for the best interests of the individual members of our society, the leaders of our society, in whose hands rest the major decisions and responsibilities for putting the various plans into operation. I certainly regret that all of our members were not able to be at the recent meetings at the International Convention, because I'm confident that all of you would share in my convictions regarding both the need, which is evident, and the men who are attempting to do something about it. Fellows, never before in one group have I seen men of such consistently high character and devotion to the best interests of other persons. They are interested in the rank and file Joe Barbershopper, you and me, because if we become better barbershoppers and prouder of our society, we will do more for the society, thereby making it a better society. Now, here are the qualifications, as I see them, of these leaders. 1, experience. They are best qualified by the many years of experience and service they have had in the society, and the familiarity they have with the problems of the society and its members. 2, knowledge. Our leaders have been aware for at least 10 years of the need for expanded services to the members, and the realization this would necessitate a major dues increase. You know, at the International Convention of 1950, it was brought out in meetings that there were numerous needs of regular members which were not being met, and in order to properly supply these various needs, more money would need to be provided from some source. Since that time, 10 years ago, numerous leaders and committees have studied the problem, and every other practical and possible solution has been tried. The leadership now concludes that the original possibility of supplying the necessary money through increased dues is still the best and most practical solution. 3, devotion. It was certainly a privilege for me to meet and talk with many of the leaders of our society and to see them in action at the various meetings, where to a man they stood for and defended their various convictions as to the best interest of our members individually and collectively. And they will certainly apply the same devotion to any expanded assignments and responsibilities they may undertake. 4, quality. Without exception, these men who are the leaders of our society acquired and developed their leadership and administrative abilities through their various business and vocational activities, and are certainly benefiting the society by donating these abilities freely and wholeheartedly to the use of the society. 5, integrity. Anytime an activity is considered which requires money or in which money is involved, there is always a tendency on the part of others to doubt the reliability or intelligent conservative dispersal of funds on the part of those expending the funds. I would like to wager that if all the expenses which district and international leaders pay out of their own pockets in a year's time were added up, it would total more than all the additional funds we will be providing through the dues increase. Fellows, let me ask you one question. Who else, anywhere in or out of our society, would be better qualified or more reliable or more interested in getting the very most additional benefits to the membership for each dollar expended? Now, let's not so tie up funds with red tape and complications that it would be impossible to properly apply them to our needs. The reason for going to some length in describing the qualifications of those who guide our society is to help you to realize that we can and should place our confidence in their ability to channel the efforts and funds to the most pressing needs and to extract the greatest benefits to the individual members for each dollar spent. As you must realize, since the proposed program of added services and benefits is a new and expanded program, many of the details as to procedure and application still remain to be worked out. Such details are mostly contingent upon the net amount of additional dollars made available for use by the necessary dues increase, with the most important needs getting first attention by the committees. Therefore, they must be worked out as the various activities are put into operation. Any given activity may require more or less dollars to operate than originally contemplated, depending upon the extent it's required to fulfill the need. And certainly, we wouldn't want unnecessary dollars spent on an activity just to comply with a preconceived budget. Therefore, flexibility must be allowed so the funds can be most wisely expended. What we should and must insist upon is that such funds, as they become available, be carefully applied to the various needs through these new services to obtain the most benefit from the funds, as determined by the judgment of these fellow barbershoppers who are so capable of accepting the responsibility. Now, the proposed new services and activities. 1, a competent staff of field representatives or troubleshooters to work with, train, and assist weak chapters and failing chapters to become strong and healthy chapters, through helping them to organize their group correctly and teaching them to attract and or develop competent leadership for their chapter, teaching them to better manage an active barbershop chapter, and teaching them to better understand and apply the skills of barbershop singing. Now, this will be accomplished through personal visits to chapters, conducting of periodic clinics on the various subjects in the various districts, and personal follow-up by the field men to see that they get off the danger list and maintain a healthy status. Also, these field men will assist chapters in organizing new chapters and helping such new chapters to become experienced, reliable, and healthy chapters. 2, a larger and more complete system of training, instructional, and stimulative material from headquarters to better enable chapters to carry out their various activities and functions. This has been promoted and carried out up to now to the best abilities of the international staff. However, they feel that much more can be provided to inform and train barbershoppers if a little more funds are made available for this purpose. 3, a better and more thorough system for giving proper recognition to individual barbershoppers for their accomplishments and or unusual contributions to barbershopping. This will require development as to ways and means as it is put in effect, and will be directed particularly toward chapter-level accomplishments. 4, publishing of the harmonizer on a monthly basis to better inform and to keep the individual members up to date on events, accomplishments, and reports within the society. It was one time hoped that this might be accomplished with funds procured through the old expansion fund plan. However, The fund failed to reach expectations and the necessary money never became available. 5. A thorough and continuing research into the problems of individual members and into the conditions and other factors which cause too great a percentage to resign. Also, determining ways in which this can be remedied and barbershopping can be made more enjoyable and rewarding to all members so they'll have greater desires to continue their barbershopping efforts. 6. To put Operation 192 into effect as it becomes feasible. Basically, the purpose of Operation 192 is to better publicize the society to the general public through TV, radio, and special barbershop concerts, thereby informing and increasing the awareness of possible prospective members about the society and the pleasures and satisfactions which may be had through being a barbershopper. Also, such top-notch publicity and high-quality performances of barbershop singing, aired or televised locally and or nationally, will give individual barbershoppers added esteem for and pride in their society, and will greatly raise the esteem and respect for barbershop singing on the part of other musicians, music editors, and the interested public. Fellows, these are the proposed activities, as I recall them, being discussed in the various meetings at the recent international convention. It's quite possible that I may have missed a point or two or overstated some. However, I believe this is a fairly complete summary of the proposed activities and some various other aspects of the issue. Certainly our society, our district, our chapter, our own chapter members are in extreme need of these added services and facilities. And if my little 75 cents a month extra will make them possible, I'm for it. How about you? The Odessa, Texas chapter has voted unanimously to approve the member benefit program as adopted by the House of Delegates at the Dallas Convention. So reported Mel Burkett. Now here is an unsolicited footnote that I, Art Baker, am putting in on my own responsibility. You know, fellows, the total annual amount of the new dues is equivalent to one prime rib dinner for four people at $3.75, and that's without a tip or without any drinks. Now, many of you may wonder how the founding fathers of our society feel about the member benefit program. Here to speak to you from Tulsa, Oklahoma, is the co-founder and first president of our society, and the original royal keeper of the minor keys. It's my privilege to introduce to you Rupert Hall.
The basic purposes of our society will never change. Of this I am certain. But we must realize the fact that our society's size, organizational structure, and methods of operation have changed and will continue to change. As I see it, the member benefit program is designed to make barbershopping more enjoyable for you and me. I'm only sorry that O.C. Cash couldn't be here to share my interest in the positive and progressive planning we are witnessing in our society today. The dedication of your chosen leaders through the past 22 years is truly amazing. God bless them for their devotion to our cause. Never before have I felt more certain than now that our officers are attempting to systematically increase our members' interest and enjoyment of barbershop harmony. Their courage in presenting the member benefit program to you is proof to me that we are heading in the right direction. Brothers, I have a grandson of whom I am very proud. I hope someday he can share the rich rewards of barbershopping. With progressive planning such as we see in the member benefit program, this young lad may find even more enjoyment in this society than his grandfather has. And I assure you it has brought me infinite satisfaction. Now, I'm no expert, but I sincerely believe you owe it to yourself, your chapter, your district, and your society to study this new plan carefully before you vote on it in your chapter meeting. This is my way of telling you that I believe in our society just as much today as I did the night O.C. Cash and I drafted our letter of invitation to the society's first meeting, which you may have read in the society's history. Thank you for giving me this chance to talk to you tonight. I hope you have many happy years with your arms around three other kindred souls, living a dream come true, the SPEBSQSA.
Our thanks to Rupert Hall for sharing his remarks with us on this important subject. And now to complete our program, we turn to our current international chorus champions from Alamo Heights, Texas.
Keep America singing all day long. All day long. What's good will come a-winging on a song. Smile while you are singing.
You are singing.
Oh,
this program has been brought to you in the hope that it will stimulate your thinking about the member benefit program and cause you to personally cast your vote when your chapter prepares to instruct its official delegate to your district convention. This is Art Baker thanking you for your attention and interest in the Society's member benefit program, in which you are being asked to help decide your Society's future course.